A very fresh morning to one and all present here. Myself Zainab Kagdi from Atmiya Green School, Jhadeshwar Branch, Bharuch. We are back with English subject for class 5th. Today we will learn about the worksheet 4, The Boy Who Saved Holland. As in our exam, two worksheets are going to come for your periodic test 2 and three lessons are going to come from your course book and the rest is from the grammar book. So today we'll undertake worksheet number 4. Whatever topics in the grammar, in the workbook, it is there in the worksheet, and whatever topics that is there in the course book, you have to prepare it very well. That grammar point is going to be asked in your periodic test and few portion will be taken even from the grammar textbook. So learn all the 3 books thoroughly, but pay more attention to this workbook and the course book. Moving ahead to The Boy Who Saved Holland, today we will discuss both the worksheet, worksheet 4 and worksheet number 5. We will undertake all the important topics which is going to come and which you need to learn it thoroughly. On page number 26, we having grammar, interrogative pronouns. So I'll request you to open up your workbook so that you can understand it easily. We already know what are pronouns. The words which replaces the nouns are called pronouns. Correct? The word which replaces nouns are called pronoun. For example, Rohan is an intelligent boy. Rohan goes to school regularly. So Rohan is an intelligent boy. He goes to school regularly. So here instead of Rohan, we use the word he. So when we replace the noun with a different word, that word is called pronoun. So today we'll learn interrogative pronouns. Interrogative pronouns are pronouns used to ask a question. So these pronouns are majorly used to ask questions. For example, who is your friend? Both the books look identical, which is yours? You can see that here. Who is your friend? And both the books look identical, which is yours? So here the word who, which, these all are called interrogative pronouns. Now we are having the exercise, fill in the blanks with interrogative pronouns to complete the sentences. Okay, first is, dash are they doing in that laboratory? So if you want to ask the question, you need to ask it with 5 W's and 1 H. So here you'll use 5 W's. Which are 5 W's, my dear student? First is what, whose, whom, who and which. These are your 5 W's which you are going to use for interrogative pronouns. Correct? So first is, what are they doing in that laboratory? Second is, I have found a purple pencil on my desk. Dash is it? Okay. Whose is it? So your whose is an interrogative pronoun. Dash did we invite as the chief guest? Whom did we invite of a person? We use whom. There are many houses on this street. Which is yours? Okay. So which is yours? So here the word which is an interrogative pronoun. So there are many houses on the street. So for house, house is a noun. This word is being used for the house. So it is a noun. So here which is used for the house. So when the 5 W's are being used in place of the noun, when we are talking about that noun and that, for that, when 5 W's are being used, it is called interrogative pronouns. Next question E is, Dash is the new librarian. Who is the new librarian? Question F, Dash did you do last weekend? What did you do last weekend? Question G, Red is my favorite color. Which is yours? So which is an interrogative pronoun? Question H. I can play tennis or swim at the gym. Which do you think is better? Okay, which do you think? Okay, which game do you think? So it is we're talking about games. So that is why it is an interrogative pronoun. Moving ahead to question number 2 on page number 26. Say whether the underlined words are used as interrogative pronouns or interrogative adjectives. Okay, so here, what are interrogative adjectives? Okay, so when the who's, which, what, and who are used before a noun, okay, when they are used before a noun, then it is called interrogative adjectives. And when the noun is being used after the noun, then it is called interrogative pronoun. I repeat, when the noun comes after the WH questions, for example, whose, which, what, whom, where, after that noun comes, then it is called interrogative adjective. Let us understand this with an example. See, whose shirt is this? Your shirt is a noun. Correct? So, whose WH question came before noun, correct? This came before noun. That is why it is called interrogative adjective. That is, IA stands for interrogative adjective. Similarly, which book? So, which is WH question? It begins with WH. Then book. Book is a noun. Okay, so WH question came before noun, that it is called interrogative adjective again. Moving ahead to question number C, who is Mr. Beam? So again, Mr. Beam is a noun. Noun means name of a person. And WH question came before it, that is why again it is a interrogative. So it is an interrogative pronoun. Why is it interrogative pronoun better? Because your WH question is there, okay, and this is Mr. Beam. But before that, before noun, there is not WH question, but there is, that is auxiliary word, correct? I'll make you understand this clearly. See, this is a noun, okay, and this is the auxiliary word. And this is a WH question, interrogative pronoun. So here you can see that before noun directly WH question doesn't come. What is coming here? WH of who? Here before noun there is an auxiliary word, that is, am, are. So when the auxiliary verb comes in between, when the noun before, exactly before a noun, there is no WH question, that it is called interrogative pronoun. You can see another example of this. I don't have a compass. So your compass is a noun. Okay. Whose can I borrow? Okay. Here again is full stop. Here again noun is coming before WH question. So it is definitely an interrogative pronoun. We're talking when after the WH question directly the noun comes. For example, whose shirt? Which book? Who? No. Here who is? Here is comes in between Mr. Beam. So Mr. Beam, before, that is a noun, and before noun there is no WH question, but there is, that is auxiliary verb, then it is called interrogative pronoun. And when WH questions comes exactly before a noun, then it is called interrogative adjective. You can see the example number 5. Where is Mont Carlo? Again, Mont Carlo is the name of the person, okay? Then it is a noun. And is an auxiliary verb. And where is a WH question? So here you can see before noun, WH question is not there. But auxiliary verb is there. So after noun, after WH question, there is an auxiliary verb but not a noun, then it is called interrogative pronoun. Clear? Moving ahead to our next important exercise, that is on your page number 34. So I'll request you to take out your page number 34. This page number 34 is from your worksheet number 5. Okay, so take out worksheet number 5, Jaldi's gift. We'll study present perfect simple. So remember the structure. First is has or have plus verb in past participle form. So your present perfect simple, we always have has or have plus verb in past participle. So here you just need to put has or have and past participle of the verb. Clear? Let us understand this with an example. Past participle, we always use e, an, or ed. You can see write will turn into written. So en, we use to convert the verb into past participle, or we add ed. Okay, here example is completed. Okay, so this is the past participle form, and you have to write has or have. Correct? Here the example is has written, have completed, has gone, have read. So here you can see has or have is being used, and the past participle form of the verb, that is verb of complete, you have to convert into past participle, that is completed, write, written. Okay, go, gone, read will remain read. Excuse me. Remember that the present perfect form could be used to talk about the following. Number first is a past experience. Okay, when we are discussing about a past experience, at that time we use this tense, that is present perfect simple tense. For example, I have tasted strawberries. Here again, have, that is has or have, tasted, taste will turn into tasted, that is a past participle form of the verb. Your ed is being used in the taste. Only D is used, okay? Only D is used in the verb taste. Strawberries. So have or has plus past participle of the form makes present perfect tense. Here when we are discussing about a past experience, at that time we use present perfect tense. Second, a change. When there is a change, I have bought a new car. When there is something new, when there is a change in something, that time we use present perfect tense. This I have bought new car. So I have bring will turn into brought. I have brought new car. A continuing situation. Okay, when there is a continuity of a certain situation, we have lived in Bangalore for 5 years now. So now indicates that it is, we are talking about present. We have lived. So again, have plus have or has plus verb, that is live will turn into lived. Again, live will turn into lived. So again, here we put D to make it present, to make it past participle. We have lived in Bangalore for 5 years now. So from now, before 5 years they have lived, and then they are still continuing to live in that place, that is in Bangalore. So that is why for continuing situation we use present perfect tense. I hope you understood the structure, that is the most important. Has or have plus verb passed in past participle form. Moving ahead to the exercise. Question number 1 says, fill in the blanks with the correct forms of the verbs given in the brackets. One has been done for you. Question A, last year I didn't know how to play chess. Now I have, the answer is given. Now I have learned it from my sister. So my dear students, you can see that learned. Learned is turned into learned. A T is being used. I have Now I have learned it from my sister. So now he has learned it. So for the continuing situation, we always used present perfect tense. Question B is, it was difficult for the villagers to cross the river before, but now they dash a bridge. Build will turn into built. That is past participle of the verb. And we have to use has or have. So here we have used have. It was difficult for the villagers to cross the river before, but now they have built a bridge. Okay. Many celebrities dash in the school. Study will turn into studied. Okay. Study will turn into studied. We have put ed here, and for y we placed I. So we used have. So many celebrities have studied in the school. Question D. Dr. Das has worked in many countries. He can speak many languages. So here has work will turn into work. ED is, we have put ED, and he can speak many languages. Question E says, the police cannot dash the prisoner anywhere. They think that he has escaped. Okay, here has plus escape will turn into escaped. Has or have, don't me say has or have plus past participle of the verb. So this makes present perfect tense. Okay, so here the police cannot find the prisoner anywhere. They think that he has escaped. So this is your activity on page number 35. Moving ahead, for the past perfect form, similarly, when the structure says has or have plus past participle form of the verb, for the past perfect tense we are having had plus past participle form of the verb. You just have to use had. I'll show you had plus past participle form of the verb. So this is your structure. Okay. Let us understand this. We use the past perfect form to refer to a time in the past and talk about an action that happened before that time. Okay. When we are talking about a situation or a event which is occurred in the past, we are talking about the time in the past and talk about an action that happened before that time. And before that time, we are talking about, at that time we use past perfect form. For example, when I started my journey, okay, when I started my journey, it had started to rain. It had. Okay, so we are talking about starting of the journey and something happened before that. Okay, that time we use past perfect tense. So it had started. So here we used had. Okay, had start will turn into started to rain. The action that happened before. Okay, we're talking about when I started my journey, it had started to rain. The child refused to eat my more food because, so this is the second example. The child refused to eat any more food. Okay, this is the first situation. Because he had eaten an earlier dinner. So, uske pehle usne kha liya hai. So, she had eaten. We'll use your past perfect tense because first is child refused. That is a verb. That event happened in the past that she's refusing. Child refused to eat any more food because she had already eaten. Your had plus eaten. Eaten, ready to eaten. Had eaten an earlier dinner. Moving ahead to important exercise that is on page number 37, question 2. Fill in the blanks by using the correct forms of the verbs given in the brackets. Here you have to use the correct form of the verbs. My friends shared. Share will turn into shared. Their breakfast with me. Okay. Because I, in the bracket is forget. Forget will turn into forget. Forgotten. Forget will turn into forgotten. Here we'll put had, that is past perfect tense. My snack box at home. So here the first statement says that my friend shared their breakfast with me because I had forgotten my snack box at home. So before at home, he forgot. So this event happened before the first event. At that time, use past perfect tense. Okay, so here the answer is shared and had forgotten. Question B says, Reema dashed to see her dog, waiting to be fed more because he dashed his meal just an hour ago. Reema was surprised. It is a past tense. Reema was surprised to see her dog waiting to be fed more because he had eaten his meal just an hour ago. So, एक घंटे पहले उसने खा लिया था. He had eaten. Okay, so that this event again occurred before the first event. So that is why we use past perfect tense. Question C. When I dashed the bus stop, I realized that I dashed the front door of my house open. When I reached the bus stop, I realized that I had left. So leave will turn into left. I had left the front door of my house open. Question D. When I went to see my friend Seema at the hospital, the nurse told me that Seema had recovered. Okay. Had recovered and she had gone home. So here we'll use in the both the times we'll use had. When I went to see my friend Seema at the hospital, the nurse told me that Seema had recovered. So when she reached, before that her friend is already recovered. So these recovery is taken place before her arrival. That is why we use here again had recovered and she had gone home. So again, when she reached, she is already left for home. So this event also happened before she arrived. So again, we'll use here had. Okay. I hope you understood this exercise regarding present perfect tense. Now we're having the last activity. Okay. Question 3 is choose the correct option to fill in the blanks in each of the following sentence. Question A. Rutvi dashed the apples before we reached there. Rutvi had plucked. So why we are using had but not have here? They have not mentioned in the fill up that you have to use only past participle or past perfect tense or present perfect tense. They have not mentioned. You have just mentioned that you need to choose the correct option, and here you have to identify that when you're talking about the first event and something has happened before that time, at that time we use past perfect tense. Rutvi dashed apples before we reached there. Okay, so Rutvi had plucked. Okay, Rutvi had plucked. She had already plucked the apples before they reached there. So here the answer is had plucked. We dashed sugar, flour, and butter before we started our journey to our village. Here again, had bought. Your word before that indicates that the thing before and because that indicates such things. Okay. Question C. When we reached, Rutvi's mother had started dicing the apples and cooking and soaking them in honey. Question D. We dashed baking the pies when the guest arrived. This is your answer. You can see it. We hadn't finished baking the pies when the guest arrived. The guest had remembered to bring chips, biscuits, and cakes to go with her pies. So your had remembered will be your answer. I hope you understood all the grammar points of your worksheet. Worksheet 4 and worksheet number 5 of your workbook. So I hope you will revise these exercises, which are the most important one, and you have to and the rest is being homework, as they are they can be done as your own. because they just need to read their comprehension. You need to just read the paragraphs and write its answers. So the rest of the exercise which we have not discussed is your homework. You have to write it on your own, as the answers may vary from person to person. That is all for today. I hope you'll do your best in the exams. Monday you're having paper of English, so I wish you all the best. Do your best, give your best, use all your ability, use all your resources, and study well and write well. Thank you.